It's with these two happy-go-lucky rogues that our story begins. For it is they who were run over by Alex Diamond. International crime fighter and playboy. Fast-moving, tough-talking, and just one of the many hundreds of famous people who suffer from lumbago. The endemic disease about which no one knows more than this man. Dr. Emil Kern. Doctor, surgeon, proctologist, and selfless fighter against human suffering, whose doorbell was the one above the hero of our story tonight, Rear Admiral Humphrey de Vere. Yes, this is the story of Rear Admiral Humphrey de Vere. And learn the true history of this man. Len Hankey, chiropodist, voyeur, pen teaser. The man of whom the chairman of Fiat once said,
"C'è cosa nell'astuccicatore di porno?"
Yes, tonight we examine the career of Gino Agnelli, the man who started from nothing to build up one of the greatest firms in Europe. The Reverend Charlie Drooper Hypersquawk Smith. The cleft-palated RAF chaplain who single-handed shot down over 500 German chaplains.
Morning, squadron leader!
What ho, Squiffy!
How was it?
Top hell! Banter's not the same if you say it's slur, Squiffy.
Hold on, man. Wingo!
Yes, bend an ear to the squadron leader's banter for a sec, would ya?
Can do.
Jolly good.
Fire away.
Oh, my God. Well, thank you, Shirley.
Sir!
What are we going to do, Shirley?
Well, we've got to act fast before it saps morale.
Sepper Walters, you stand before this court accused of carrying on the war by other than warlike means. To wit, that you did, on April the 16th, 1942, dressed up as a bag of dainties, flick wet towels at the enemy during the important offensive.
Well, sir...
Shut up! Colonel Fawcett for the prosecution.
Sir, we all know...
Shut up!
Excitement of a night emission over Germany. When the pilot Jennifer has to choose between his secret love for Louis, the hot-bloodedly bisexual navigator, and Andy, the rear gunner, who, though quite assertive with girls, tends to take the submissive role in his relationships with men. And sensational Mexican starlet Rosetta Nixon plays the head of Bomber Command, whose passion for seabirds ends in tragedy. And Roger, as Pip, the half-parrot, half-man, half-woman, three-quarter badger, ex-bigamist...
There! On the lawn!
No, no, Dan. Just the word.
Don't antelope nibbling the hoops.
No, no. Antelope. Sort of nice and woody type of thing.
Don't think so, Becky, old chap.
No, no. Antelope, antelope, tinny sort of word. Oh, sorry, old man.
Really, Mansfield?
Well, she's got to come to terms with these things.
Oh, what rotten luck. Yeah, well, whole afternoon to kill. Better have a bath, I suppose.
Gervais, do sing me a song.
Oh, okay.
Something woody.
For... She's going to marry on you! Oh, crikey. Old song's finished her off.
What?
Oh, I'm afraid that Mrs. Vermin Jones appears to have passed off.
Dead, is she?
Afraid so.
What a blow for her.
What I want to know, Mrs. Elizabeth III, is why they show us crap like this when there's bits of the list of bypass would have never been shown.
Yes, all that sort of thing. And I'm just getting really fed.
Do the bit about alas, poor Yorick.
No, I'm sick of it. I want to do something else.
And you've got her legs up against the mantelpiece.
All right, Mr. Hamlet, I'll take over. Morning, Mr. Hamlet. My name's Natal. Sorry to keep you waiting. Now, what seems to be the problem?
Girl, well, Ben, you've had a few drinks, you've got a sweater up, and she's got her feet on the mantelpiece. Yes, what is it?
There's a proper psychiatrist to see you, Dr. Rubensberg.
Oh, my God. OK, thank you.
On behalf of the Psychiatric Association, I should like to say that we are taking firm action to clamp down on the activities of bogus psychiatrists.
We sent our reporter, John Dull, to find out.
On London's busy Westminster Bridge, seeing just how much time sitting down can take.
It's been stolen.
What?
This belongs to Mrs. Edgeworth of Pinner. She's standing over there.
Mary.
Tell me I'm beautiful.
Well, you are.
Oh, Robert, do you mean that?
Of course I do.
You're not just saying it because I asked you to.
Of course not.
Oh, fair Ophelia, nymph, in thy orisons be all my sins remembered.
So anyway, you've got the girl on the bed and her legs are on the mouth.
Oh, wasn't he great, my boy?
He was great, Mr. Gabriello.
The way he kept on fighting after his head came off.
He was better when the head came off, Mr. Gabriello. He was really dodging the guy.
Oh, what? What do you want?
Is your boy's head?
No, we got his head. He ain't hurt that bad.
Hey, that's Jerry Marinello. He fought the killer last week.
And it's 12:30 and time for The Robinsons. An everyday story of bloody, 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 blah.
Hello, Mrs. Robinson.
Morning, Mrs. Non-Robinson. Been shopping?
No,
I've been shopping. What did you buy?
A piston engine.
What did you buy that for? It was a bargain.
Bloody rubbish.
I wanted to listen to that.
Morning, Mrs. Gorilla.
Morning, Mrs. Non-Gorilla.
Have you been shopping?
No, been shopping.
Hello, Mrs. Smoker.
Hello, Mrs. Non-Smoker.
Have you been shopping, then?
No, I've been shopping.
Well, now it's time for racing, so let's go straight over to Epsom and Brian McNulty.
Well, over here at Epsom, there are chances of plenty for those who want to make a good start in,
Dentistry.
Good afternoon. Well, in fact, there's still a few minutes to go before the main race on the card this afternoon, the Queen Victoria Handicap. So let's have a quick word with the winner of the last race, one of this season's top jockeys, Ronnie Mau Mau. Good afternoon, Ronnie.
Afternoon, Brian.
A very fine ride there, Ronnie.
Well, fine horse, Brian. You know, you can't go wrong.
Well, let's just see if a colleague of yours agrees with that. Let's have a quick word with Desmond Willett. Afternoon, Des.
Good afternoon, Brian. No chance, no chance at all.
No, I think you're wrong there, Des. I think with the right kind of going, he's going to be in there at the finish, Des.
No chance, there's no chance.
Well, in fact, I can see last season's top jockey, Johnny Knowles. Good afternoon, Johnny.
Hello, Brian.
Can we have a box for Johnny, please? Thank you.
Hello, Brian.
That's better. Well, there you are, three very well-known faces from the racing world. Thanks very much for coming along this afternoon, lads. Good afternoon, so let's go right away and join Peter at the start.
Well, they're under starter's orders for this very valuable Queen Victoria Handicap. And they're off. And Queen Victoria is the clean jump ball, followed by Queen Victoria, Queen Victoria, and Queen Victoria. It's Queen Victoria, Queen Victoria, Queen Victoria making the...
And now he's off. So let's see a playback of that. Brian.
Yes. Well, as you can see, there's Atana now. He gets the through ball from Gomez. And he makes no attempt to play the ball. He quite deliberately lets off.
Jimmy? What do you mean?
Well, the referees really are clamping down these days.
Good evening.
We've got the girl on the bed, her legs up on the mantelpiece.
Come on, put on. Out!